Asato ma sadgamaya, tamaso ma jyotirgamaya, mrityor ma amritam gamaya. Asato ma sadgamaya,
our planet has been around for about 4,500 million years. In its early years, it was far too hot and dangerous to support life. But as the Earth cooled, its surface became calmer. Steamy water vapor from the constant eruptions formed clouds and rain fell. In this water, life appeared over 3,500 million years ago. Biologists classify all living things in groups, including class, order, family, genus, and species. Mammals. Human beings belong to the class of animals called mammals. There are about 4,000 species of mammals, including such animals as cats, dogs, elephants, and others. All mammals have a backbone, hair, four limbs, and a constant body temperature. Female mammals are the only animals with special glands that produce milk for feeding the young ones. Primates. Human beings, along with apes, monkeys, lemurs, and tarsiers, make up the order of mammals called primates. Scientists classify human beings and apes in the superfamily Hominoidea. The family of Hominoidea consists of human beings and their closest pre-human ancestors. Human beings and their primates share many physical features. Both human beings and apes rely on their excellent vision for much of their information about their environment. All primates see in color. Human beings and apes also have a highly developed nervous system and a large brain. Human beings and many other primates have long, flexible fingers and opposing thumbs. Their fingers and toes have nails instead of claws. The physical characteristics that distinguish human beings from other primates are related to the ability of people to stand upright and walk on two legs due to powerful long legs and strong muscles. Apes spend most of their time climbing in trees or walking on four limbs. The human spine, unlike the spine of any other animal, has a curve in its lower back. This curve helps make upright posture possible by placing the body's center of gravity directly over the pelvis. Apes use all four limbs to support their weight, and they grasp objects with their feet and their hands. Anthropologists believe that human beings, chimpanzees and gorillas all developed from a common ancestor that lived from 14 to 18 million years ago. The direct ancestor of human beings was a creature called Ramapithecus, which lived from 8 to 14 million years ago. Discoveries of Ramapithecus fossils in China and Pakistan indicated that the creature was an ape. There are four sorts of apes: chimpanzees, gorillas, orangutans, and gibbons. Chimpanzees. Apes are the closest relatives of people. Chimpanzees are the animals which remind us most of ourselves because of their facial expressions and the way they play games, make tools, and solve puzzles. Chimpanzees live in groups, which sometimes fight neighboring groups. Their main food are fruits, leaves, seeds, flowers. Chimpanzees live deep in the forests and open grasslands of Africa. Gorillas. Gorillas are the biggest and strongest apes, but they are gentle giants. Gorillas live in small groups that travel slowly through the forest, eating some but not all of the food in one area before moving on to another feeding area. Orangutans. Orangutans are richly colored and found in the forests of Southeast Asia. Orangutans spend most of their time high up in the trees, searching for fruits, shoots, leaves, and insects. They live alone, except during the breeding season. Gibbons. Gibbons' muscular arms and hands are so long that the knuckles touch the ground even when the gibbon stands upright. Gibbons live in a family group of a male, a female, and two or four young ones. Modern man. The first prehistoric people with modern human features appeared about 100,000 years ago in either the Middle East or in Africa. The people had a chin and smaller, less protruding face than earlier Homo sapiens. The first physically modern human beings lacked the large brow ridge of earlier people and had a higher and more rounded skull. Throughout the early stages of human evolution, the rate of cultural change among prehistoric people was extremely slow. However, about 35,000 years ago, the rate of cultural change began to accelerate rapidly. These early humans spread slowly over the rest of the world and soon rose to dominate life on Earth. Evolution of modern man. Let's imagine that we can go back to a time to see what living things looked like millions of years ago. That is impossible, but we can find out a lot about the past by looking at fossils. Fossils show that living things have gradually changed over many millions of years. Some kinds have become extinct, and new kinds have developed from older ones. This process of slow change is called evolution. The 19th century biologist Charles Darwin hit upon the answer. He shocked the world when he wrote that humans are related to apes. Darwin's book, On the Origin of Species, published in 1859, explains the theory of evolution. The first part of the theory is called variation. All living things vary in size, shape, color, and strength. The second part is that these variations affect whether or not a living thing can survive and breed. The third part of the theory is inheritance. Human beings and apes, such as chimpanzees and gorillas, share a common ancestor. To support this theory, it's pointed out that the fossilized remains of ancient human-like beings and apes reveal many similarities, including similar brain sizes. Scientists comparing the physical structure, blood, and genetic material of modern humans with those of the apes found that people are more similar to apes than to any other living animal. The ancestors of human beings began evolving separately from the ancestors of the apes between about 10 million and 5 million years ago. This evolutionary split marks the beginning of the development of hominids. The first hominids were human-like creatures called Australopithecus, which first appeared more than 4 million years ago in Africa. The most complete Australopithecine fossil scientists found is a partial skeleton of a female found at Hadar, Ethiopia, nicknamed Lucy, about 110 centimeters tall and weighing about 30 kilograms. Homo habilis, meaning human being, lived in Africa about 2 million years ago. The Homo habilis brain was about half the size of that of a modern human being. Many anthropologists believe that Homo habilis made the first tools. Fossil evidence indicates that by 1.5 million years ago, Homo habilis had evolved into a more advanced human species called Homo erectus, meaning upright posture, and found in Africa. Homo erectus was probably the first human being to master the use of fire. Homo erectus moved into the northern areas and faced cold winters, and hence they wore clothing made of animal hides. Between about 40,000 and 30,000 years ago, Homo erectus evolved into a new human species called Homo sapiens, meaning wise human being. Homo sapiens had a brain nearly as large as that of modern human brains. The Neanderthals were a type of early Homo sapiens who lived in parts of Europe and the Middle East from about 1,30,000 years to about 35,000 years ago. The Neanderthals were more skilled hunters and toolmakers. Neanderthal graves suggest that they were the first to bury their dead. Throughout the early stages of human evolution, the rate of cultural change among prehistoric people was extremely slow. However, about 30,000 years ago, the rate of cultural change began to accelerate rapidly. The best known type of human beings from this period are the Cro-Magnons. The Cro-Magnons lived in Europe, the Middle East, and North America from about 40,000 to about 10,000 years ago, and scientists believe they resembled modern Europeans. Human races of the world. Human beings belong to primates, the highest order of mammals. A developed brain, hands which move freely, flat nails, and keen eyesight are the major characteristics of the primates. The ability of man to stand erect . His locomotion . Coordination of brain and hands . And the composition of blood are much similar to those of the apes. But his ability to make and use different types of tools make him different from the other primates. The apes are believed to be the predecessors of mankind, evolved from a common ancestor which existed about 18 million years ago. The last stage of evolution occurred about 5 lakh years ago. Scientists are of the opinion that Homo sapiens, the ancestors of man, appeared in that period. Although Homo sapiens have certain common traits based on the color of skin, the shape of the head, nature of hair, and body stature, they are broadly divided into different human races: Negroid, Mongoloid, and Caucasoid. Negroid. The characteristics of the Negroid race are clearly seen in the Negroes of Sudan. We call them Capris. The Negroid race are spread over the arid regions of Africa. Black curly hair, black or brown complexion, a brown iris, broad and flat nose, long head, thick lips, and slightly protruded teeth are the characteristics of this race. Mongoloid. The important characteristics of the Mongoloid race are their flat nose and saffron or yellowish-brown skin. Body hair is comparatively less and they are short-statured people. The people of China, Korea and Japan are of Mongoloid race. People of this race are also found in India. The Eskimos are one among the many subclasses of the Mongoloid race. It is believed that the Eskimos originated from the Bering Strait about 5,000 years ago. Then they spread over Northeast Canada and Greenland through Alaska. Fish, beaver, reindeer and the seal form the food items of the Eskimos. The Eskimos make their houses with ice blocks. They cut the ice into square blocks and arrange them in a circular shape around. When it is completed, they would get trapped in the house, which is called igloo. The floor of the igloo will be much below the ground level, and there will be an opening to reach the ground. Caucasoid. The complexion of the people belonging to the Caucasoid race is pale red or white, or the color of olive oil. They have light brown or golden hair, light blue or dark iris, long nose, thin lips, and they are tall and have a well-built body. The Celts are a class of Caucasoid race once spread over Western Europe, and they frightened the Romans and the Greeks. The Celts kept livestock for food and dairy products. Their huts were covered with clay and thatched to protect them from bad weather. Today they inhabit only the western region of Scotland, Ireland, Wales and France. As time elapsed, marital relations between different races led to the emergence of mixed racial groups. Today, each major race has a number of sub-races and mixed races. In short, there is no such thing as racial purity.
This educational television program was presented by the State Institute of Educational Technology, Government of Kerala. Your observations and suggestions regarding this program may be sent to
the Director, SIET, TNF5, Cotton Hill Square, Thaikkad PO, Trivandrum 14, phone 0471-233-8541, 233-8540, fax 0471-233-8540, email saetkerala@gmail.com, website www.saetkerala.com.